The bird was much bigger than a blackbird and didn't have a friendly yellow beak, and Curtly felt a little worried. What is it? Why is it trying to get in? Is it trying to get me? He asked.
Of course it's not trying to get you. It's not even trying to get in. Look, when your curtains are pulled, the window is like a mirror and it can see its reflection. Only it doesn't know it's a reflection. It thinks it's pecking at another crow. That's what it is, a crow. I looked it up. I think it lives in those tall trees in the rough ground. The nature reserve, Curtly said. Do you think it's jealous because we haven't put any food out for it?
No, Dad smiled.
If it's jealous, it is jealous of that big black crow it can see in the window.
It's reflection.
Silly crow, Curtly said. But the crow wasn't silly. It turned out to be a very clever bird. It often visited Curtly's garden, and even though it was much too big to use the bird feeders, it worked out ways to get food from the feeding station. Curtly loved watching it strutting on the lawn as it figured out how to get the seeds. Curtly and his dad never did fix up that special basketball hoop. Instead, they put up more wildlife cameras and more bird feeders. They also cut holes in the fence so that the animals that couldn't fly, like hedgehogs, could visit. Their garden became so wildlife-friendly that their neighbours started putting up bird feeders in their gardens as well. And the rock farm behind the garden became a real nature reserve, lots of birds nesting there. There were never any lions or wolves. Sometimes, when his curtains were closed, Curtly still heard the tapping. And was glad that his very own big bad wolf turned out to have feathers instead of fur, and pecked at his reflection instead of howling at the moon.
CBeebies Radio, it's a world of pure imagination.
Time to go and sacrifice the things you like.